وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى in today's session إن شاء الله تعالى I want us to talk about the tafsir of the ayah يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he informs the believers who believed in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and believed in the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the fasting of Ramadan is an obligation on them. Because Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. And we know the famous statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, which Ibn Abi Hatim narrated in his tafsir, Abu Nu'aym also narrated in his kitab, Hilyatul Awliya wa Tabaqatul Asfiya, wa sahaha isnadahu, Imam Ahmad Shakir in his kitab Umdatul Tafsir, that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, إِذَا سَمِعْتَ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ If you hear Allah saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Those of you who believe, فَأَرْعِهَا سَمْعَكَ Bring your ears close. If you hear Allah saying in the Qur'an, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَأَرْعِهَا سَمْعَكَ Bring your ear close. فَإِنَّهُ خَيْرٌ يَأْمُرُ بِهِ It is either good Allah is commanding you أو شَرٌّ يَنْهَى عَنْهُ Or it's evil in which Allah تبارك وتعالى is warning you against. So now that يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا has been used, we need to listen. What is it that Allah is going to command us? Or what evil is He going to warn us from subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Those of you who believe, كُتِبَ The word kutiba, it means furida. Fasting has been prescribed. It has been made obligatory on you. Kutiba alaykumu as-siyam. Fasting has been made obligatory on you. Fasting, what does it mean? In the sharia, fasting means huwa ta'abbudu lillahi. It is to worship Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. By what? Bil imsaki anil akli. By with refraining from eating, والشرب and drinking, والجماع and sexual intercourse with your partner, from when? من طلوع الفجر إلى غروب الشمس, until from Fajr to Maghrib. From Fajr to Maghrib. And this is what Al-Imam Ibn Jarir Al-Tabari mentions in his tafsir. Al-Imam Ibn Kathir also mentions it in his tafsir, Ibn Kathir. And also Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he mentions it in the 25th volume in his Majmu'u al-Fatawa rahimahullah. So it is that you worship Allah and it's an act of worship. Fasting is a ibadah. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us sallallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, يَدَعُ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ He leaves his drinking, he leaves off his eating, وَشَهْوَتَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي And he leaves off fulfilling his desires for whose sake? For Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's sake. So we're all doing it for Allah's sake, bi'idhni Allah al-Kareem. So it is at-ta'abbudu lillahi, it's an act of worship. Fasting is an act of worship. And you're worshipping Allah by doing what? Bil imsaki, to refrain from. Anil akli, you don't eat. Wa shurbi, you don't drink. Wal jima'a, sexual intercourse. Min turu'i al-fajri. Also, in there you could say وَسَائِرِ الْمُفَطِّرَاتِ and all the other things that break your fasting. There are other things that take the place of drinking and eating or sexual intercourse. For example, having injections that give you nutrition to the body, they are or any supplements that a person takes that gives them الْأَكْلِ and it takes the place of drinking and eating, breaks your fast. Masturbation, for example, it takes the place of jima', sexual intercourse. It breaks your fast. Okay, ponder on that. Then the ayah says, كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ As it was made, يعني فُرِضَتْ عَلَيْكُمْ عِبَادَةُ الصِّيَامِ The fasting has been made obligatory on you, كَمَا فُرِضَتْ أَيْضًا The way that it was also made obligatory on who? عَلَى الْأُمَمِ السَّابِقَةِ The previous nations. Now this is called tashbih, brothers and sisters. Tashbih means what, brothers and sisters? Allah is comparing our fasting to their fasting. But the scholars, they discussed it amongst themselves. Ibn Kathir mentions it, rahimahullah ta'ala. Al-Shaykh Abdulrahman Nasir al-Sa'di also mentions it. Which is what? This tashbih, what is it? Some scholars, they said that tashbih here is fi asri fardhi sawm. The tashbih here is that the fasting, it was made obligatory on them, and it's also originally, yeah, it was originally made obligatory on them as it was made obligatory on us. But it's not لا في قدري وكيفيتي ووقتي. It's not in terms of its timing and the amount and the weight. No. Just that fasting was made obligatory on them and it was also made obligatory on us. That's it. That's the comparison here, the obligation. And that's the view Ibn al-Qayyim pushed strongly in his kitab Jala'ul Afham في فضل الصلاة على خير الأنام. Ibn Ashur also chose that opinion and he pushed it in his tafsir. And also Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen رحمه الله تعالى. There's a second view which say كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. They say this tashbih is referring to في الوقت, in terms of the timing. In other words, they're saying that this fasting has been made obligatory on this ummah in this same time as it was done in the previous nations. Yani fasting was made obligatory on us this time in Ramadan, and also the previous nations, they used to also fast this time of the year, which is Ramadan as well. There wasn't another time they used to fast. It wasn't like Muharram they fasted. No. فُرِضَتْ عَلَى هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ صَوْمُ شَهْرَ رَمَضَانِ كَمَا فُرِضَ صَوْمُ عَلَى الْأُمَمِ السَّابِقَةِ. This is the view Ibn Jarir al-Tabari pushed, rahimahullah. And he chose this opinion. And he said this is what is meant by it. And there are also others, A'imatu al-Salaf, who said it. Go to the tafsir Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, you'll find it there, bi'idhni Allahi al-Kareem. Another group of scholars, they say no. The tashbih here is ala sifati as-sawm, the way that the fasting is actually done. Ya'ni, we are prevented from three things, right, which we mentioned. Min al-akli, wal-shurb, wal-jima', right? These three are what we're not allowed to do. We're not allowed to have sexual intercourse. We're not allowed to drink or eat. That's the same thing for them. The same thing was يعني made from them, prohibited. This is the view that Abdullah ibn Umar said, Abdullah ibn Abbas said, Abu al-Aliyah said this, Abdurrahman ibn Abi Layla said this, Mujahid ibn Jabrin said this, Sa'id ibn Jubayrin said this, Maqat ibn Hayyan said this, Al-Rabi' ibn Anas said this, Ata' al-Khurasani mentioned this, Suddi mentioned this, there's many imams that mentioned this. You can find it in Tafsir ibn Jarir al-Tabari and Tafsir ibn Abi Hatim. Another group of scholars, they said, no, the tashbih here is fi fard siyami thalathati ayyam min kulli shahr wa yawmi ashura. That the fasting of the 3 days of every month and Yawm Ashura, the beginning of Islam, was obligatory on us, right? Remember, brothers and sisters, the same thing was for the previous nations, such as كَمَا كَانَ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ قَبْلُ لَدَ الْيَهُودِ. The Jews were like that. The Jews, they used to fast every month, 3 times a day, yani 3 days within every month, and they used to also fast Yawm Ashura. It was obligatory on them. Same thing for us in the beginning of Islam, before Ramadan got made obligatory. This is the view pushed by Abdullah ibn Abbas also. Al-Dhahhak ibn Muzahim. Qatada, Ata'. You can find it in Tafsir ibn Jarir al-Tabariyu and Tafsir ibn Abi Hatim. So that's what the view is when it comes to كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Now what does it mean لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ? I want to focus on this. This, what it means is لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ means a من أجل الوصول بصيامكم إلى مرتبة التقوى. This fasting that you're doing, it can be, it will be, if you do it in the right way, it's going to be a means for you to attain taqwa. It's going to allow you to attain a station known as taqwa. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make us from the muttaqin. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, in his kitab al-istighatha, في الرد على البكري ابن تيمية, the first volume, page 275. Ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله, he discusses this in great details and talks about it. رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. I'm going to stop there inshallah ta'ala for this episode. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمد أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله استغفرك وأتوب إليه.
Ramadan with AMAU. Make this the best Ramadan you've ever had by joining our exclusive online community with regular private classes, digital resources, weekly accountability sessions, and daily Qur'an gatherings. This is one opportunity you definitely do not want to miss. So sign up now at amau.org/Ramadan, and we look forward to welcoming you on the other side.